Can't believe we don't have a show yet. Who would have thought 10 minutes before the show, I wouldn't have any ideas. Oh, I didn't see it there. Please, tell me you didn't hear what I was just saying. Listen, you can't tell anybody that we don't have a show for tonight, okay? Everybody's backstage waiting for me. They expect a script. They expect dance numbers. I got nothing. You know, they're counting on me. And the worst part is, this isn't even my fault. This is Mr. Bike's fault. For years, he's been talking about how he's going to quit the faculty play and run off to Broadway. None of us ever supported him. The guy's not a very good actor. But earlier this year, our English class was trying to think of a way to get rid of him. They came up with this brilliant idea. Off he went.
The case of the Sussex vampire has been settled, and without the use of a wooden stake.
Why do you torture us like this?
It's called acting. I've always been told I'm a good actor.
Oh yeah, you're great.
You really think so? You know, for years I've been saying I might go take a shot at Broadway. I just haven't had much support from people around here. I think they're afraid they won't be able to put on the faculty play without me.
We actually put on a show before you got here, and we could do it again. I mean, I've always assumed you'd get fired or something.
What a joker.
I really think you should go for a Broadway show. In fact, I think you should go right now.
But we still have 20 minutes left in class. And it's only September. I really should give the school district some notice.
I bet they don't even notice.
Well, he's got a point there. But really, guys, let's not fill Mr. Bike's head with nonsense. You know how impressionable he is.
You know, I used to think you didn't believe in my abilities, but now I know you're afraid of what will happen to your little show if I'm gone. You can't survive without me.
I'm actually looking out for you. I don't want you to embarrass yourself.
Do you guys think I can do it?
Would you leave right now?
Heck yeah!
Go for it!
Thanks, guys. See, bro? They know what they're talking about. I'm out of here!
Oh! I'll never forget you guys! Come see me in New York!
What are you guys doing? You know he can't make it out there on his own!
But at least we'll enjoy class a little bit more. He was always hogging the big parts.
And the small parts.
We sat here every day listening to him perform plays.
And he was horrible!
Initially, it didn't seem like that big a deal. We had done a show without Mr. Bike before, and it was pretty successful. So I figured we'd be able to do it again, no problem. But then I sat down and figured some things out, and I went blank. I couldn't come up with anything. I don't know if it was because the first show didn't have a story, or if I got so used to making fun of Mr. Bike that I couldn't think of anything else. But I panicked. I did what anybody would do. I asked the cast for ideas.
A lot of kids ask me what teachers do after school ends. What if we did a reality play?
This is a story of seven strangers picked to live in a school.
And have their lives taped.
To see what happens.
When people stop being polite.
And start getting real.
The real world, Memorial. It's been difficult living in this school with these people. Everybody, no one admits to doing anything wrong. Everybody's got an excuse for everything, especially Tom Lynch. Hey Lynch, have you seen my toothbrush anywhere?
Yeah, what's it look like?
It's white with blue on it.
You mean like this?
Yeah, how did you not know that's not yours?
Look, I'm blind, okay?
Tom is always pulling the blind card.
So is everybody having a great day?
Yep.
Yeah,
so
yeah,
far.
It's been
two
days.
It's
good.
I really enjoyed his hay lunch.
Hey, thanks.
Hey, where are you taking my apple?
I'm blind.
It wasn't that bad an idea. I just don't think people are ready for that kind of look into our lives yet. But then, I got a little glimmer of hope. Mr. Bike called me. This was sometime in October, I think.
Hey, bro. Hey, I was just calling to ask you something. Hey, does the school know that I'm not there anymore? I just got another paycheck today. They've been coming this whole time.
Well, for the last 4 weeks or so, whenever anybody asks where you are, I just tell them you're in the bathroom.
That explains it. Hey, how are things there? How's the faculty play coming?
No, things are great. The faculty play is great. Everything's going really well. But how are things with you? Have you gotten your big break yet?
Oh, I got a ton of scripts coming in. I just haven't chosen one yet. Anyway, I gotta go. I gotta work on a monologue. All right, I'll see you later.
Jesus is here? No, that's not it. Are you talking to Jesus? Yeah, that's the one.
I think the show should be about me.
Mr. Abood's idea. I just don't think anybody would buy tickets to a show like that. I decided it was time to call Mr. Bike and see if maybe he was ready to give up his pipe dream. But all I got was more bad news. So, I just figured I'd check in, see how things are going.
Oh man, things are going great. You know, I finally got my big break. You wouldn't believe the part I'm playing.
Really? Wow. Good for you, bro. I mean, I'd like to say I always believed you could do it, but I guess I never really did. I'm sorry I wasn't more supportive. Listen, if you get a chance, maybe you can come see our show. I mean, it won't be the same without you, but we're still going to put on a heck of a show.
Yeah, we'll see. You know, things are going great. I'm really, I think they're really going to want me to play this part for a long time. You know, I'll see. If I get a chance, I'll stop by.
Okay, well, I'll talk to you later. Hey, break a leg.
Okay, thanks. Okay, Keith, remember, be the hot dog. Be the hot dog. Be the hot dog. Be the hot dog.
Get your New York City hot dogs here! New York City hot dogs! Get them here!
I think we should just go back to the classics. You can't go wrong with Shakespeare.
She speaks! Oh, speak again, bright angel, for thou art as glorious to this night, being over my head, as is a winged angel messenger of heaven. Ought to be bright or white, upturned, wondering eyes of mortals that fall back to gaze on him when he besides the lazy, lazy, pacing clouds and sails upon the bosom of the air.
O Romeo, O Romeo, whereabout are you, Romeo?
And that's where you came in. We're doomed. I don't know what we're gonna do when the show was supposed to start 2 minutes ago. I guess I'm just gonna have to go down there and tell them we don't have a show this year.
Hey, bro.